Many names were swirling backstage, many qualified names. Mike Adamle's, as far as my knowledge, wasn't one of them. So why did you choose Mike Adamle?
To make him crazy, Goofy.
There's no one more qualified and has a total picture of what happens with not only front office politics, as well as locker room politics, how everyone gets together, as well as being in front of the camera and has the business acumen to be able to pull it all together. There's nobody more qualified than Mike Adamle. Qualified, yes. I am looking forward to working with the superstars. This is just an amazing, amazing opportunity.
You apologize like nothing happened. Like you didn't knock me on my ass in front of millions of people worldwide. Now I'm gonna come down there and work with you. I'm not coming back. And now I'm gonna show the whole world why for 7 years in ECW I was the unscripted, uncensored, loose cannon of commentary. WWE called me. And from week one, week after week,
Mike Adamle,
you're ignoring the moves and the holds. It's damn insulting for the athletes, the wrestlers, not the entertainers, who leave their families 300 days a year to fly their
in ECW, I called live pay-per-views on my own, solo, no color commentators dragging me down. Wasn't done before me, hasn't been done since. I never needed this job, and I don't want this job anymore. I quit.
And it's my great pleasure to welcome my new broadcast partner, 5-year veteran of the WWE announced team, right here, baby, Todd Grisham. Todd, welcome to ECW.
Hey, thanks. It's great to be here. And there's been some confusion. Am I supposed to call you Taz or The Taz?
You see, that's the thing. Just Taz will be fine, thanks. Right. I get nightmares when I hear The Taz.
And we go into the ring with a Taz.
Wow.